Hey y'all, this is Anirudh Biswas. Today I'm going to show one demo on AI, which is in still in preview mode in Power Apps. Okay, so before that, let me introduce myself. I am Anirudh Biswas. I have 12 years of experience in different technologies, mostly in SharePoint. Last 10 years I am working in SharePoint in different flavor. Apart from that, last 2 years extensively I am working in Power Apps. Flow and Power BI, actually in Power Platform. Okay, so let's go to the demo. Okay, yeah, so this is the first screen. In this screen, there are two options. One is options where you actually scanned all the data and you can get the list of the contacts, and second one is scan the card. So I am going to scan the card. So in this scan the card, you can click on business, scan business card, and some of the sample business card I actually downloaded from websites, different websites. So let's do one. Okay, so this is the actually component newly introduced by Microsoft. This component is like you need to browse one card and it take all the name, phone number and email ID and scan it and put in a particular places. Okay, if you submit it, it actually go to the back end. There is a SharePoint list. In this SharePoint list you can find whatever entry it is. Now the list of the contacts you can find that also. There is a search which is by default. You can go and search, and if you want to call you can just click. Now this is website, I mean this is a web browser, so there is a no default phone dialer. So when you click on the on your phone, automatically it will call that particular person. Or if you want to mail, default mail client will be open with some subject lines. Okay, now question is how I have developed this thing. Okay, so let's show you. First of all, this is one particular component. So now for you, if you go to the insert tab, there is a new tab. Earlier it was not there. Okay, you just cannot do business card scan. Other than that, you can take one component, new component, object detector, form processor, and some other features also. Okay, so for this, let's say create one screen. Okay, I'm going to create one business card large. Next is you need to go one form. You need to place one form. Okay. Now, in the data source, let's say in the data source, I have already placed one SharePoint list. Okay, business card contacts. So in this SharePoint list, I actually put some columns: name, email ID, phone number two. Many columns you can put it here. Based on the, I mean, property you can received after the scan. Okay, so let's put this source business card contacts here. Okay, now which column you want? One is must be name. Okay, another should be email. Next may be phone, phone 2, etc, etc. Okay, oh, I put a name. Oh, let me delete it. Remove. There must be a title. Okay, actually for the title column I renamed, that's why it is like this. So you can drag and drop. So So name will be the first one. Okay. Okay. Now the question is, if you run it, it will not render. Okay, because the default mode of this form one is edit actually. So you make it new. So when you put it new, it will be there. Okay, it's not the column actually. I'm sorry for that. This is the actual thing. So it will be new. Okay, now what is the name of this object? It is business card reader one. So take it here, unlock properties dot. Now you can see there are many properties are there. Company name you can detect from their business card, department, email, many other things. So right now I am just looking at name. If name is there, first name is there, okay, or full name. Let's say I need full name. Okay, for the email you need to put the same thing. So you need to just unlock, put it there. Let's say this is the name and it will be email or something like that. Okay, for phone number, again you need to do this. Go to phone number dot phone one. So there are three property: phone 1, phone 2, phone 3. Some of the cards have so many phone numbers, so it can be allowed for at least three numbers are there. Okay, I'm stopping here. I'm not doing any more properties one by one. So let's put one button. Okay, I'm putting one button. Here is my button. Oops. Let's put it here. Okay, this is a submit button. You can rename it later. Usually we do btn submit or something like that if you wish. Okay, so on click of this submit button, we can do submit form. What is the name of the form? Form name is form 2, I guess. Form 2. Okay, so I'll put it like this. And here you can navigate to success message or something like that. It is your wish. Well, let's say navigate. I want to navigate home screen. Earlier there are two mandatory parameters for navigate. You need to tell the transition type. Now it is not needed anymore. If you are in Power Apps, if you are a Power Apps developer, every day there is something new. Earlier, if you put semicolon at the end, there is an error message. Now nothing is there. So it is fantastic. It is actually changing every day. It is helping us to, build fantastic apps in a quick time. Okay, so let's do another scan. I'm doing this one. Yeah, it is doing fantastic job. Now I submit. Yeah, so if I go here, I need to clean the search box, and here it is, it came. Okay, that means in the back end you can see it. Is not it fantastic? You can actually get this kind of small app in very quick time. Now I will show how I have developed this area. So this is a normal gallery, browse gallery. You can get one screen for that, list gallery or something like that. I have designed all this thing. Click on particular image, you can understand that there is a launch keyword. This is a function and you need to put your mail to subject body. If you are Power Apps for a long time, you can gradually understand that Power Apps actually one HTML component kind of things. Actually it is done in the browser, in the phone, different type of phones, platforms, Android, iOS, and everywhere. And this mail to kind of things we actually used earlier in HTML in a tag, correct? In the anchor tag, In the href, we usually put mail to or something like that, and it works. Phone number, it works similar kind of things. So tell is the keyword, colon slash slash, and then you need to put your phone number. In the HTML page, you can put same thing and it will work. So more or less, if you understand HTML from the very beginning, it will be very easy to debug sometimes in the browser to what is happening at the back end. Okay, so I hope I give you some tips on this area. Okay, in the let me know how the things is from your side. If you have something interesting, let me know. Okay, till then, bye.